Hey everyone, welcome back to Figure Fantasy. So, as you can see, our next figure is incoming. You guys are probably familiar with that picture from the game, from the new event of Rin. So, it's also a sneak preview of the next figure that we're going to get. And if you guys are not familiar who that chair belongs to, I'll give you a clue. So she's a cutie, and again, she sits on that chair while she's in battle. So let's check her out. Okay, so it's going to be Ai Hinohara for that chair. So it belongs to her, and she is going to be a kind of a hard, hard figure to get because of her team. So let's get out of this and let's take a look at some of the details that she has for her figure. So she is with Ninth Nine. So, and also she is a militarist. So she's going to be difficult to get. Currently we do have an event for the brand exclusives. We have Norris with the rate up banner. So if you guys are going to pull for Ai Hinohara, please do consider saving up your Fully Wish. So the Fully Wish is going to be your star currency that you guys are collecting to pull for either Snow A or Night 9 figures. It's for the brand exclusive. So let's go through Ai Hinohara's skills. See if she is worth the pull, but I think she is. Norris is more of a specialist, while Ai Hinohara, let's see how she can, you know, impact your team. So let's go straight to her attack skill. So she's given priority to the front enemy in the same horizontal row as you, so usual for any ranged or militarist unit. Normal attack increases up to 50% when you upgrade up to level 3. This is going to be her ultimate, her technical skill. So randomly attacks two enemies with the enemy in front of you and mark for 5 seconds. So she'll be putting a mark on them and randomly attacking. This attack is given by randomly selecting one of the following debuffs. So take note, she's going to be crucial in giving out debuffs. Fainting for 1 second, freezing, burning, 10 energy, minus 10 energy, disarmament, and silence. I think fainting is going to be your sleeping. So, sorry for the translation. This is coming from Figure Story in the Japanese version. So, as you can see there, attacks 2, then mark, then a couple of either one of the debuffs. But once you upgrade the skill, when you activate the ultimate for the first time, the damage is increased by 100%. So double the damage. And when the ultimate is activated for the first time, all 6 types of debuffs will be granted. So that is how incredible this skill is. So she is most likely to be good with PvP and small unit type of matchups of 5. So again, I think she's going to be another game changer of a figure. So for her passive skill, inflicts additional damage on all ultimate mark enemies with each normal attack. So once they are marked with the ultimate, then there's an additional damage for each normal attack if they attack the same figure with the mark. So if you want to level this up to 2 and 3, increases damage to enemies in frozen or flaming enemies with normal attacks and phantom techniques by 25%. So increased damage for those who are frozen or ignited, or I'm not sure what is a phantom technique, but there's an increase of 25%. If the ultimate grants an enemy a frozen or burning condition, his attack speed will increase by 40% for 5 seconds. And for her exclusive skill, this is going to be a special skill. So increased damage dealt, increased attack and attack speed, and increased damage by 20% when there are no enemies around. So obviously, I is going to be crucial because she's going to put out debuffs, especially for the first time when she does her ultimate, when this takes effect, the all six types of debuffs are granted. They're going to be useless for what? Around a difference of between 1 to 5 seconds. So each debuff is going to be, you know, taking effect differently and also have a different duration. So, but again, if you could pull off her ultimate a couple of times, then this will really, really kind of be beneficial to you. She is kind of similar to what I forgot her name. Let's look for her. The girl that does silence. So Sakura, I think that's Sakura. So she is going to be really, really good. So if you are not into pulling for Norris, you might actually consider pulling for Ai Hinohara. I'm sure as well that her her skin will be dropping as well when she drops. So also please do watch out for the skin. This looks good. This looks like a roulette table. So again, she has the same passive more or less in terms of function as what Sakura does, but it's more of a more various more debuffs in terms of what Sakura can give out. So again, thank you guys for staying this far. So hopefully you have an insight already of what's going to drop next, and probably she is going to drop, I'm looking at January 21, because we did get our new figures on the 7th, and it's usually every other week that we get two figures. So my best guess is going to be January 21 for her. So please watch out for her, and please do make sure that you have saved up your fully wishes by the time she drops. Okay guys, again, thank you for staying this far, please consider subscribing because this helps my channel a lot. Thank you guys, stay safe, take care. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.